Hey, hey, hey. This is Rachel, the Modern Shaman, and I am going to answer another Q&A question in just a second. But before I do, I will say that you can connect with me on my website, which is themodernshaman.net. And if you want to view any of these videos later, you can go to my YouTube channel, which is just The Modern Shaman. Okay, so here's the next question on my list. I'm just going to read it. Sorry, I just ate some of those goldfish. Okay, you talk a lot about the power of breathing. Can you give some tips for breath work? This has always been a hard meditative practice for me. Okay. You're not alone in that. It was really hard for me at the beginning. This was actually the first way that I was introduced to meditation, because this is my father's preferred method of meditating. And when he was meditating and I was young and I would see him, you know, he would be in his closet with the door closed and all the lights off in there. And of course that just makes a kid want to come in there, you know, what's daddy doing in there? And so one day he said, come in, I'll teach you how to do this. So the way that he taught me, the first way was by counting as you're breathing. So exhaling out to the count of, I think it was 5 or 10, you know, I was little. And inhaling the same number, inhaling to the count of 5, and then doing a cleansing breath in and out in between each counting breath. And this was so hard for me. I don't know if it's just because it was a kid, but it almost made me feel like I was suffocating. I was like, you know, I couldn't do it right. And like, it made me so conscious of my breath that it did. It made me feel like I was choking. I couldn't breathe suddenly. I didn't remember how to do it. So I ditched that, and went to mantras soon after that, when I told him how hard it was for me. And he gave me, the first mantra I ever had was, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. He is, he was, and he is to come. Which I still love that mantra. But mantras worked much better for me. And naturally my breathing would be controlled as I was repeating that phrase, because it almost puts you into a natural breathing rhythm. But since then, I've kind of felt into how breath work best suits me, which is something we all have to do with spiritual practices. What works for somebody else may not work for you. So instead of just ditching it altogether, you can just kind of feel into a better assimilation of that process in your own life. So that it's actually, you know, practicable, something that you can do. So I do breath work and kind of what I consider shamanic energy movement. So pulling energy from the earth, moving energy within my body. Tai Chi kind of does this, the movement and flow of physical energy, but also, you know, I can see it, so I'm seeing these colors and energy that I'm moving, but also it can just be done with the breath, the intake, and really managing your energy intake and exhale with your breaths. So I'll give you a few techniques or tips, and again, process this as you will. First off, if you love breath work, I should have my dad on here to talk about all the breath work that he does, because this is, again, his main way, but he also loves the focus on the space in between breaths and extending that space in between breaths to the null zone and extending that null zone. That's a beautiful practice. I can do that now. I couldn't do that when I was younger. But that's a beautiful, peaceful, emptying meditative practice to focus on the space in between your breaths, just to breathe naturally, but have your pointed focus on that space in between. And then once you've got it there, notice it extending its spaciousness, its timeness, to where you're sitting more and more in the space of empty, of nothingness, but allness. It's a beautiful place. That's one breathing exercise. Another is to, like I said, I am more active in my breath work, so I like to, I don't know if I'm gonna do it right now, but physically move my hands with my breath and kind of push and pull as I'm breathing. So I like to pull the energy of Mother Earth, for instance, and Father Sky, and bridge them within my own heart chakra. I've done a meditation with this before. I think it's on YouTube. But I didn't necessarily do, so a lot of times I'll physically move. So I don't think I can do it in here. This is my office and it's kind of messy. I can't get all the way down. But basically I'll squat down. If I'm outside, I'll actually like touch and move the earth. I should just do a video on this process. And I will pull the energy and I'll just, and hold it in my body or circulate it. And then I will push it out. And then I'll pull from the sky and just all the way in and try and hold it and then push it out. And this kind of becomes a dance, and I'll just kind of move it through my body as I feel where I want to hold the energy, which it looks probably crazy to an outsider, but I love this aspect of breath work because it's connecting my physical body to my internal body with the breath that I feel coming in. And you know, you can feel your inside breath. You can feel it in your chest as it's colder or expanded. And you're letting that fresh oxygen in and oxygenating all of your cells. You can literally feel that. So I love to tune into that feeling as I'm doing it, and really move that oxygenated energy throughout my body. That's a more, like I said, a shamanic energy movement, but that's one that I like to do. You can do that with any type of breathing. I also like to focus where I'm putting my breath. So if I notice that, for instance, I do this all the time because my shoulders hold tension. So if I notice that my shoulders are feeling tense and I'm tightening them up, or my jaw, I do that too. I clench my jaw sometimes. If I'm doing that and I notice it, then I will just take a few minutes, and my next few breaths, I'm not really conscious of how I'm breathing or how long or how much I'm taking in, but I just focus the energy and I set that intention to send that fresh oxygenated blood into that area. And I see it kind of dissipating the tension and the muscle tightness and kind of getting in there in each little connective tissue and spreading breath in there, life, energy, oxygen. So, for instance, I'll just do this. I'll focus on my shoulder. And I just send the energy there. It feels really good. When you do this, you'll feel a difference. I feel it like just right away. I can just feel it in there and it just sets me at ease. Same within my jaw. If I'm tensing it there, I can just send it there. And your body responds pretty quickly. Breath work in conjunction with mantras is also very common, and I love that too. Holding kind of a breathing pattern as you are saying a mantra. This is also super effective when you're walking or jogging. I used to run track and I loved doing this. When I would get, you know, in your zone and you kind of have that rhythm to your feet hitting the floor. So you're hearing that boom, 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 you're hearing that. And your breath has now also has a rhythm. It's like, or whatever you're doing. That was mine. I would typically do two outs and one in. breath, and then finding a mantra that goes with that. Just even just one word. I love the word holy. I love that energy. And it's a short, syllabled word, so it's easy to do with quick breaths like that. Just holy, 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 holy. And just moving again, I like to connect my physical body with the internal. So now you've got your mind, you've got your physical body, and then you've got your internal breath work all in alignment with that pattern. It's very effective to just set you into that peaceful state or whatever state you're choosing to energetically connect to, like if it's the word holy or peace or joy or whatever it is that you're wanting to connect and assimilate in your body. It's 10 minutes. Gosh, these 10-minute videos go fast. Okay, I'm going to stop there. If you have any more questions with breath work, again, there's a ton you can do with this, but those are some of my faves. Hope you're blessed.